guys, welcome back to Sunday School here at First United Methodist Church. I hope y'all had an absolutely amazing week. And for some of you guys, it was the first week that you were back in person, in the classroom, in school. And I hope you had so much fun seeing your friends and seeing your teachers. We are always praying for you. So feel free to have your mom or dad help you and give us a call or send us an email so we can know how to be in prayer for you and what's going on in your life. We're going to read a story this morning called The Disciples from our Spark Story Bible. Let's see what Jesus is up to in this story for us this week. Jesus told everyone he met, "Repent, stop the bad things you are doing, and start doing good." One day, Jesus was at the seashore, and a crowd gathered to listen to hear what he had to say. Jesus hopped onto a fishing boat so more people could see and hear him. "Thanks for letting me use your boat," Jesus said. Then he said to one of the fishing brothers, Simon and Andrew, "I want to thank you with lots of fish. Throw out your nets." "We'll try," they sighed. Simon and Andrew put their nets into the water. "But we fished all night and caught absolutely nothing," they explained to Jesus. Suddenly, they felt their nets tug. They were overflowing with fish. Rip, pop, snap. The nets were so full they were breaking. The brothers pulled in so many fish that their boat started to sink. "Help," they called to their friends in another boat. "We have too many fish." James and John rushed to their rescue. The weight of the fish almost took their boat under too. They knew that their new friend Jesus must be someone special. He was the one who told them to catch those fish. "Hey, Simon and Andrew. Hey, James and John. Follow me," Jesus called to them. "Let's catch people instead of fish." Splash! The two sets of brothers dropped their nets into the sea. They were not fishermen anymore. Now they were disciples. They would follow Jesus. Jesus met a tax collector at his office. "Hey, Matthew, follow me," Jesus called. "Let's collect people instead of money." Clink! Matthew the tax collector dropped his coins to the ground. He was not a tax collector anymore. Now he was a disciple. He would follow Jesus. Jesus met seven others that day. Philip, Bartholomew, Thomas, another James, Thaddeus, another Simon, and Judas. "Follow me," Jesus said to each of them. Crash, boing, boom. They all stopped and dropped what they were doing. Now they were disciples. They would follow Jesus. Jesus and his 12 friends, the disciples, shared the workload with many other followers, including Mary Magdalene, Joanna, and Susanna. No matter where he went, Jesus called for men and women, boys and girls, to drop what they were doing and follow him. Guys, Jesus calls us to be disciples too, people who follow him with our lives. We're called to love like him and live like him. To love the people that he loved and do some of the things that he did. We're called to be his hands and his feet in our world now. So we're not just who we once were before we knew Jesus, but instead we're new people given a new identity and a new job to be his disciples and his followers. You know, a really fun game you could play today would be follow the leader. You can take turns being the leader because I want everybody to have a turn to be a follower and know what it feels like to follow someone else's lead. What kind of leader do you want to be in this life? Do you want to be the kind of leader that leads other people to Jesus? I hope so, because really the best leaders are people who follow Jesus each and every single day. Have a great afternoon, friends, and we look forward to seeing you back next week. Bye, y'all.